That is some weird, wild stuff. That is funny. I did not know that.
Yes! Dropping drawers and stabbing whores on the Kevin Holly Show.
And I gotta say, he has balls. This man has balls. He's flinging them out there for us to see.
That's a really sounds like our first date kit.
Ever shared a lustful evening with a Muslim woman?
We're dropping drawers and stabbing whores. It's the Kevin Holly Show.
Party boy, Jay's party boy.
This is the part when anybody's got a dollar for Jay, you gotta give it up.
Right on. Come on, let's go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Kevin Holly Show. We are live. It is episode 25. This is the first live show of our second season. What is it today? July 4th, 1776, something like that, Jay?
1775.
1775? Yeah. Something like that, whatever.
This all is going to be a crazy show right here, I can tell right now.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, Kevin. Who's in the studio, man?
Oh, all right, well.
Oh, my God, we got a house full.
We've got Homeless Chuck on the green lampshade mic, of course. Homeless Chuck, welcome. I'm glad you made it on time.
I'm the man in the box.
We got Jaybird in the house right next to me. Crowd my space tonight, Jay. Don't spill your vodka, whatever the hell that is. What is that, an apple teeny? Don't spill that on my 15-year-old laptop. That'd be great. We've got a special guest band in the studio tonight, live. These guys are awesome. We've got the band Slingshot Robot. Everybody's been very excited about that. So we've got those guys here. Pops is in the kitchen still eating. He'll get in here as soon as he can. We're going to have to move that.
Dinah's still out there.
Who?
Dinah.
Dinah who?
Dinah's in the kitchen.
Dinah's in the kitchen? I don't think I'm old enough to get that reference, bro.
Pops will, don't worry. Right?
He'll be like, what?
Who? I cut Pop's ear off. He thinks he's in the studio right now, dude. So.
He thinks he's catching a buzz.
Yeah, that's awesome. He thinks he's in the podcast. Right
All now. Right, well, hey, without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and throw out the phone numbers tonight. God. Hotline tonight, 727-237-6010. We will be taking live phone calls all night. Also, if you want to chat us up on mixlr.com, feel free. There's a chat feature. Of course, hit us up on Twitter throughout the show. We'll be checking our Twitter. That's at Kevin Holly Show 4, the number 4. And of course, our Facebook is basically facebook.com/ The Kevin Holly Show. Also, check out Slingshot Robot throughout the show. They've got their own Facebook page as well. It's pretty simple. If you can't type in Slingshot Robot, then you're probably one of our best listeners. That's pretty awesome.
Or you're listening. Yeah, you're listening every week.
Right on.
Slingshot Robot.
Let's get right into this band here, because I know these guys, they're busy guys. I know Doug's got to work in the morning. We pulled him out of nowhere here. We got Doug, we've got Ed, we've got Harold, and we've got Al. That is Slingshot Robot.
Absolutely.
Thank you guys so much for showing up tonight. A lot of people probably don't know that Al and I actually go back way, way back, at least, 5 years, something like that. My kids attend a dance school, and so did his kids, or I think it was just your daughter, right? One daughter? Yeah.
Well, actually, both of them were.
Was it both of them? I can't remember. I'm stupid.
Wait a minute.
I'm sorry. Can I interject something?
No.
You said that you knew Al from the Nutcracker years and years ago. I swear to God, I thought you meant that you and Al performed together.
That's what I
thought. We did.
Did you think
that's
that?
What I thought
okay,
too.
Okay. So I'm not the only odd man out.
No, I thought that
no.
Too.
Well, judging by your choice of clothing tonight, you are
the
only
odd man out.
I got my
shaggy shirt on, baby. Yeah,
we did perform in the Nutcracker.
We did. That's what I'm trying to say.
You were performing in it. You
You're right.
You know, Chuck, I can break it down for you. Basically, our children were in a dance school, okay? And mine were the youngest ones, you know, the little ones, like 4 years old, 7 years
were
old, something like that.
Were you in the play yourself? Did you have a role?
Well, if you ever watched the Nutcracker in a live performance, like a playwright style, okay?
There's yeah, a I parent. Just freeze frame it at a particular
I'm
moment.
I'm sure you did, yeah.
It's but okay.
It is the world's most boring thing.
It was fun to do it, though.
No, I thought you actually talked. I thought you were childhood friends.
No, 5 years ago? Really?
Okay. You never said five.
Oh, if you were paying attention. Active listening, Chuck. Active listening, Chuck.
I just get lost in your eyes.
Basically, they put on a performance every year for the Nutcracker. We go to the high school, you know, and they have a huge performance with all the kids, and they all do the dance numbers. It's a whole real feature Nutcracker, and there's a parent scene in the very beginning. It's like the opening scene where the parents all come out, and they're having a dinner party. You know, and you know, watch the Nutcracker.
Okay. I wanna bring this show
yeah,
back
yeah,
to some
relevant. Rock and roll, baby. I don't think anybody's interested in
Nutcracker right now.
Speaking of cracking nuts, why are you busting my balls, man?
How about some ball busting rock and roll?
Really?
All right.
Let's go.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Ball busting rock and roll.
Let's give everybody a second to introduce themselves, man.
Yeah. Let's go around the room left to right. We'll start with Doug. He's closest to the mic. Doug. What's up, man? Let's talk a little bit about you. You've been playing music for how long?
Since high school.
Since high school. There you go. All right. And that was what, like 2 years ago?
Yeah, a couple years ago. I just got recently graduated, but no, probably, 12 years.
Nice.
Right on. Cool.
And then we've got Ed. I like the shirt, by the way, man. I got a couple of short sleeve button down mechanic style shirts like that.
Yeah.
Like rocking those shirts, man.
Yeah, that's what I was going for. I didn't
He's like, that's what I was going for. I just left work.
Kevin's wardrobe.
I come over here to help show.
So Ed is lead vocals and guitar. I'm sorry, Doug. Ed, you play, I would imagine, rhythm guitar background vocals, whatnot. Cool. You've been playing a long time too. I don't even know how old you are. You look about my age, maybe a little younger, something like that.
That's how old you are, I guess.
My God, Kevin, are you hitting on him?
Dude, I hit on everybody, bro. Of course. Well, you just wait till the third hour, Chuck. I'll be hitting on you again, dude.
Change wardrobes.
Thanks. My mom's listening, Chuck. All right, thanks.
I don't want
to
ask you beers for that, man.
Oh,
speaking of your mom.
Gotta turn that ringtone down, man. Anyway, so, Ed, you've been playing music for, what, about the same amount of time? How long?
Yeah, since I realized the girls liked it.
Right on.
There you go.
Yeah. I'm so freaking lit.
Man, that sounded creepy.
Everything Chuck says sounds creepy. Get used to it, man. Holy crap. All right, so we got Harold. What's up with Harold, man? I like the beard you got going on there. It's a little bit better than Camden's, and fuck Camden, man. I can't stand that. So how long you been playing music?
Like 20 years.
20 years. All right. What's your biggest influence? What makes you want to pick up that electric guitar and jam out?
Originally, just other bands.
Just other bands?
Yeah, you know.
Anybody in particular?
Who's your guitar hero?
Back then, I don't know. A lot now, but...
Couple. Just give us one or two.
Back when I was a teenager, it was Metallica and stuff like that.
He kind of looks... He does look a little bit like James Hetfield.
What's in your car right now? If you get in your car and you fire it up.
Well, it'd be on my phone, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, I forget. I was old school. Shit. Jesus Christ. We cranked the cars back in my day.
See, if I were you, I'd be playing songs myself, so I'd have my own CD in the car. I'd be like,
yeah, our CD just done, so I've been listening to that mostly. Right.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You're playing an electric carving guitar?
Yeah.
What do you think of that? Is that something?
Great. It's a good company. They're factory direct to get it. $3,000
guitar
for like
$1,000.
There you go, dude. You just got a plug for that. You got a check coming in the mail.
You guys may know some of my background, but I used to shoot for Armadillo and HHI guitars. I shot for those guys for years and years doing all their catalogs.
You're not getting paid for that, Chuck. But come on, man. Okay. We got one more person.
We got
Al
over there on the bongos, obviously the drummer in the band. Yeah, from the Nutcracker.
Never start with the Nutcracker. We're gonna put it on the album now.
Yeah, that'll be your third, your next album. Be the
Why
Nutcracker.
Not
Nutcracker.
Do a version? Absolutely.
You know what?
No.
Yeah.
Now I remember talking to you guys earlier in the week, and somebody said my elder is in the band. That was Doug. Who's your elder? When you guys are related? You're talking about Al?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I played with Al forever. We played in like three bands together, I think.
Nice.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah.
You guys are trying to sound. I tell you, you got such an interesting and I love your compositions and I love the way they go and the ups and downs. I'm telling you, man, I'm absolutely mystified about your music.
Oh, thank
you. Really, you know, not some. The acoustic versions are taking me away, man.
These are different songs. Yeah, we have two groups of songs we play. Right. So sometimes we play our heavier stuff, or you know, for certain shows, and other times we play our acoustic songs.
We can play
anything. No, I am telling you tonight, you guys are absolutely spot on, clean notes. Are clean.
Chuck, are you hitting on him, dude?
No, Kevin, I figured.
A lot going on. You're next, Harry.
Actually, I'm not.
All right, so should they play some stuff?
Do you guys,
they're itching, man. I can see. Yeah, they're like ready, dude.
He has not taken his hands off the fret and or off. No, they're all. It's like gunslingers. They're ready to shoot, baby.
All right, Chuck. Let's let these guys play out. What are you gonna play?
Play happiness.
Sure.
All yeah. Right.
All right. All right. So this is called happiness.
Happiness. All right. Cool. Here we go. Slingshot Robot.
Live life like there's no tomorrow. Beat it.